John Blackstar, astronaut. Is swept through a black hole into an ancient alien universe. Trapped on the planet Sagar, Blackstar is rescued by the tiny Trobit people. In turn, he joins their fight for freedom against the cruel overlord. Who rules by the might of the Power Star. The Power Star is split into the Power Sword and the Star Sword. And so, with Star Sword in hand, Blackstar, together with his allies, sets out to save the planet Sagar. This is his destiny. I am John Blackstar.
The last of them, Balkar. Every fruit and nut in the Sagar tree.
Good harvest, Trobits. 100 power fruits and 100 knowledge nuts. All right, who took the nuts?
Not me.
Riff!
Well, only a couple.
Hey! Jumping gumbos! Yoda, put me down! Put me down!
Nuts!
The fruits and nuts are loaded and ready for delivery.
Then let's not keep the Merminites waiting. They're meeting us at the Red Crown Reef.
Are they coming, Queen Brindell? The Trobits come each year to the Red Crown Reef, don't they? They're bringing us the fruits and nuts from the Sagar tray, aren't they?
Yes, Puffin. Feast here now. The Trobits grow near.
Oh no! It got me! It is! Typhon! He's come back! As a ghost!
Overlord will be pleased, Captain Typhoot. Brindle Sea is in your control.
Not yet, Sirk. Not until I capture the Trobit's fruits and nuts.
Made it, Trobits! Brindle Sea of Tranquility.
There she blows! Brindell's Red Crown Reef!
Yay! Yay!
But where's Brindell?
Brindell?
A phantom ship.
get those fruits and nuts! Of Sega. I feel its power. Get back there. I must have the knowledge, nuts, and the Trobbits as well. My spell. Ahoy, mates! Bring me those knowledge nuts! The nuts! They're gone! What? You swabs, I want those nuts! I need them! Find them!
What in the world?
Brindell, where are all your people?
Captured by Typhot, the Phantom Captain.
Typhot? Yeah, we met him. What is he?
A distant ancestor of the Overlord. Long, long ago, the Golden Galleon protected our sea, and its kindly crew gave the mystical fruits and nuts of Sega to my people. But an ill wind brought Typhon's pirate ship to our waters. And the golden craft was wrecked. My people rescued the galleon's crew, and by the power and knowledge of Sega, we turned back the pirate forces. spirit of Typhot returned from the deep to take my people and my sea.
Could it be Merminites?
I'm afraid not.
Going anywhere, Trobbits! You'll stay put, and when I get those knowledge nuts, you'll teach me how to use them. Never. It's a secret.
Never, ever. Never!
Then I'll turn you all into serpents.
Well, you see, you use them like this.
Think about it. My crew should be back with the nuts momentarily.
Lock onto it, Mara!
One Trobbit escaped. And one Merminite. They have the knowledge nuts of Sagar.
Gee, Pulo, I've never been here before. How did we get here? I don't know where we are. Do you know where we are? I guess we're lost. Do you think we're lost? Kind of lonely here, but it looks like a good place to think. Thinking's fun sometimes. Do you do much thinking? Knowledge nuts. Oh, they're good for thinking, aren't they? Maybe we'll think of a way out of this mess, huh? Something's in there, Pulo. We both know it. But how do we move that rock? We're not strong enough, are we?
Thank you.
Well, tell me, where are those knowledge nuts?
We don't know.
Then cast them in with the Mermanites.
Those aren't Mermanites.
Them's your serpents.
They're Mermanites. I turned them into serpents with my newfound power. And now to turn you Trobbits into serpents as well. After them!
Captain! Captain! On the horizon! Look!
It can't be! It is!
The Golden Galleon. 40 knots. And gaining speed. Have they spotted us, clone?
Looks like it. They're coming straight at us.
I'll sink that Golden Galleon once and for all. Release the Mermanite Serpent!
The Power Fruit!
Quick! To the Trobbit boat!
The Star Sword!
Fire one!
Serpents are starting a whirlpool!
We're going down!
Are we going down? I don't want to go down. Do you want to go down?
Look! The Trobbit boat!
Balcar! Get back! Those serpents will sink you!
They're not serpents!
They're Mermanites! Under Typhon's power spell!
And now, with the knowledge nuts, my powers will be unbeatable. Your star sword can't harm me, Black Star.
Go off to the Overlord's Ice Palace,
where they'll be royally chewed out.
So, that's what I think. What do you think, Pulo? Should we ask Bindel? Yes, let's ask Bindel. She'll know. Queen Bindel.
Yes, Puffin.
Pulo wants to know, why do the knowledge nuts turn the serpents back into Mermanites, huh? Can you tell him why?
Why do you think, Puffin?
Well, because the knowledge in the nuts is good, and it can't be used for evil, and it was stronger than Typhon's evil powers. Is that right?
Exactly.
Well, Well, that's what I told you, Pluto. Why didn't you listen to me? Well, if you're not going to listen, I just won't talk. I'll just stop talking altogether. You won't hear a word from me. Not one more word. Now, some others I know just never stop talking. They talk and talk and talk and talk. And talk and talk, but not me. Oh, no. When I decide to stop talking, I just stop talking. You won't hear another beep out of me.
Imagine, if you will, the circus amusement park, life-size. With magic, there is always a trick.
Wow.
Impressive. Very impressive indeed.
Making a big top disappear. What a great publicity stunt for the new amusement park, Senator.
And, above all, a great publicity stunt for me. I find your proposal quite intriguing, Mr. Cooper. Surely we'll be in contact with you to work out all the details. After you, Mr. Cooper.
Thank you.
Senator, it looks like your life is hanging from a thread.
This is Duke Paparazzo with breaking news coming to you live from the Electro City Hall. All concerns and efforts here are focused on Senator Dobbs, his secretary, a Miss Shirley Linguist, and world-renowned magician Ace Cooper, who are trapped in an elevator that hangs precariously by one thin cable 24 stories high up in City Hall.
Well, what are you waiting for? An invitation to the funeral?
Captain, all of the doors are blocked.
What? Get out of the way. Blow the door open. Clear this crowd out immediately.
Something, Cooper. You're the magician, aren't you?
Exactly, Senator. A magician, not an explosives expert. A bomb?
Help! Help!
Don't advance any further.
all now. And I warn you right now, the slightest provocation and I hit the detonator. And then you can say goodbye to Dobbs.
No! Help me!
What do we do now, Captain?
He's bluffing. We're going in.
What? No, don't move. The staircase might be rigged with explosives, too.
The elevator goes next.
Nobody move!
This madman is controlling everything with his computer.
Why me?
Cosmo, do you read me?
You have to get into City Hall's mainframe computer.
Hang in there, Ace. I'm on it, man.
Listen, mister. What is it that you want from us? I can get you anything you want. Money, a passport, a plane out of the country.
I want you to return the money, Dobbs. The money you have been embezzling from the funds of the construction of the circus amusement park.
What are you talking about? This is totally absurd.
You have 10 minutes, Senator. After which time, Electro City will have to elect a new leader.
Access refused, Cosmo.
This psycho is no dummy. He's locked all the systems, and he's the only one who can control them. Yes. Hey, Angel, I've got an idea.
Senator, I wonder if maybe you could...
Are you losing your mind? You don't expect me to give in just to please this crackpot.
Time is running out.
No! It worked. Okay, Angel, you should be able to hook me up to Ace now.
As you wish, Cosmo.
Ace, Cosmo here.
Hey.
Okay, man, I've just introduced a virus into the City Hall's mainframe. The bomber can't see anything on his screen, and he has momentarily lost contact.
Meaning?
Well, it should take him, like, you know, 2 minutes maximum to figure out the virus and neutralize it.
Cosmo, I've always appreciated your sense of timing.
Get ready. You should know the hierarchy of City Hall.
Oh, I'm so sorry. After you, Senator.
Thank you, Miss Lindquist. Cowards first.
If they think they can outsmart me, they've got another thing coming to them. Just a bit.
Thanks, Cooper. Cooper, not only have you saved a life, but you have just
saved... Get out of the
saved...
way, Dobbs. The bomb's about to go off.
Ace, he's already figured out the code to the virus.
Miss, hurry up.
In my stocking.
No!
During this most harrowing of events, each and every one of the people involved proved his calm and his courage beyond a doubt. But above all, I would like to extend my enormous gratitude to Ace Cooper. Without his help, I fear that the rest of us might no longer be of this world.
Senator, what do you have to say about the allegations leveled at you by the hostage taker concerning certain financial dealings?
Unmitigated lies from the mouth of a psychopath, a complete madman, desperate for attention.
Our financial records here at City Hall are impeccable.
Tell us, Mr. Cooper, what happened up there?
I'll get you to confess in the end, Dobbs. And this time, no Ace Cooper to save the day.
I thought I ordered you to get rid of him.
Well, that's what I did. I had him fired.
That is not at all what I meant when I said get rid of.
Cosmo, I owe you one for this.
That dude who pulled it off is like a hacker genius.
This whole thing stinks. Convinced that Dobbs was hiding something.
You mean this is a job for the magician?
Could be.
Hey, finally I've been trying to reach you. Can you stop by the office?
I'll be right there.
About 2 weeks ago, a man came storming into headquarters, screaming about having discovered embezzlement and other dirty dealings.
And you think that's our hostage taker?
Entirely possible. He seemed right off his rocker. Friedrichs had him thrown out without even questioning him.
And what do you know about him?
Just that he claims to have worked at City Hall.
There you go, Lieutenant. This is the last file of City Hall employees.
None of them look like the guy we're looking for. Hey, sorry, Ace. I guess I'm barking at the wrong tree. I might be losing my intuition.
Miss Lesage, see if you can find a file on former employees.
Yes. Here's a file of terminated employees.
Hi, my name's Bill Peach, and I'm responsible for computer accounts.
That's him. I was right after all.
That's strange. According to the information we have here, Peach was a model employee. He worked overtime every evening and even on weekends. Seems like City Hall was his whole life.
Hey, this neighborhood is really quiet.
Yeah. We're gonna have to use the silencing.
You know, even though I know this guy is a psycho, I get the feeling he isn't all that bad.
You seem to forget that he almost had 3 people killed, including you.
Compliments of Senator Dobbs.
Let's get out of here.
These guys look like they're up to no good.
They're coming! Open this darn door!
I know them. They're hired assassins.
Peach!
Too late.
It's just a mannequin. Peach outsmarted him this time.
What a pity, Mr. Cooper. You're too late.
Hey, all of these blueprints. It's the Magic Express. Cosmo's in danger. Angel, Cosmo, come in. Do you read me?
Ace, I'm having a systems malfunction. Someone has introduced a virus into my system.
Ace, look!
Ace! Watch out!
they ever improve their motion signaling?
Attention all units. There's an out-of-control train speeding down the expressway, heading for Sunset Boulevard.
The Magic Express! Bring in the helicopter! Angel, what is going on here? Angel, the door, please!
Cosmo, I have lost control over the Magic Express's operation system.
Angel, open the flippin' door!
What? A mad train? What? Peaches on TV? Are you sure?
This train is now under my control, and I've directed it towards the circus amusement park.
My park? That madman wants to destroy my park!
Dobbs, if you don't return the money, you and you alone will be responsible for the deaths of thousands of people.
This guy is stark raving mad.
I never thought he would have gone this far. Senator, I wonder if maybe...
Out of the question! I will not give in to this... psycho!
But, Senator, the circus is full of innocent people!
Lieutenant Vega, in the back of the helicopter there are some explosives. Use them to stop the Magic Express!
But there are people in that train.
I don't care, Lieutenant. You are the only one who can stop the train now. That's an order. Do you understand?
If we want to stand a chance of catching up with the Magic Express, we've got to lighten our load.
Magic Force, reveal the power within!
Using my own weapons against me.
Show us how you dance, Mr. Cooper.
Good work, Ace.
Angel, open the door.
Let me help you with that.
Cosmo, you shouldn't. It's too dangerous.
Hey, I'll ask for your opinion when I need it, okay? Oh. Oh, man, my head. What happened to me?
Are you okay, Cosmo?
But Ace... Dude, how did you...
I got in through the trap door that you use every night to sneak out to the dance club.
You knew? Cooper!
Angel, access all of your operational functions.
Well, Ace.
Hey, what's going on with Angel anyway?
Peach must have reinforced the virus. Get out of the way, Cosmo.
The only way we can get rid of the stupid virus, Ace, is to reboot Angel's original software, file by file.
Okay, I'll try and distract Angel while you look after the computer mainframe. Let's go!
Peach!
You're not going to get off so easily, Ace.
Not a second to lose!
So much perseverance! You guys are pathetic! D-
adult move, Lieutenant.
Stop the massacre before it's too late, Peach. You know darn well the Dobbs will never return the money.
Don't worry. I can stop this. The remote control. It must have gotten broken in the accident.
Come on, you stupid machine. Please, give me a break.
Why didn't they return the money? It's all his fault.
His fault?
I didn't want to take such drastic measures.
What's that, Mommy?
Happy to be back.
Angel, hit the brakes!
Whoa!
Look, Mommy! It's the magician!
Ace, you're alive!
And what about the money Dobbs has extorted?
We'll find a way to sort it out. You can count on me.
You should return the money.
No! No way! This money is mine!
Fine. You'll run the risk of being sent to jail.
Well, then do something about it. I have no intention of going to jail.
There's only one solution. We have to transfer the money from the fake invoices into another account.
I can't believe this. The money's disappeared.
What do you mean, disappeared?
Bingamundo. 10 million electro dollars for an association which helps put the unemployed back to work.
Good move, Cosmo. I'm sure that Peach would appreciate your kind gesture.
You can never fool the magician.
I guess tutoring on the road has its advantages.
So check it out.
But there's nothing like being in a real school.
So explain to people out there about Hamlet. Check it out, all right? Hamlet is crazy. He thinks he's the craziest dude, man.
The school's a big part of a kid's life.
Read a book, man. Go to the library, you know what I'm saying?
It's one-on-one, and you can learn, you know, more, but sometimes you just want to be with your friends and hang out and goof around.
Back in them days, you couldn't really express your feelings. Good overcame and got back at evil.
Someday, just go into a regular school with regular kids and just have a normal day of school.
Kids my age go to school with other kids. Sweet deal. Me, I'm number one in my class. Number one and only.
Hey,
gotta do your homework, Joe!
Yo, Joe, you made it!
Studying in solitary is not happening.
Had to bust out.
Done already? Must have jammed on your homework.
Well, no. That's why I left. I mean, I'm solo in there.
Gotta do your homework, Joe.
Hey, wait! Come back!
Joe? Joe? I need a status report. Still on that math assignment?
Sorry, Einstein. Looks good, Teach. Coming right along.
Perhaps this would be an apt opportunity for a break.
Waiting!
Mr. Scott, I believe we should discuss Joe.
I knew the day was going too smooth. What's wrong?
I believe Joe longs for an educational environment with normal peer interaction.
You mean he wants to go to a regular high school?
Just for one day! Come on, John!
Today? Right now? No way!
Quit riffing, John. We got time before the show.
Jordan's right. Joey Joe here hardly got a chance to see what high school was like.
Yeah, thanks, Danny. I'd just like to try out a school that doesn't have four wheels. How am I ever gonna know what I'm missing if I don't check out the scene?
Step off, John. We owe this to Joe.
Okay, Donnie, but you're forgetting about...
Word up, gentlemen.
Biscuit!
B-Man, our favorite bodyguard.
Just talking about you, B-Man. You gotta try out our chill in the video game.
Sorry, Nico. Game time.
This game was custom made just for us.
Hey! Huh? Well, let's check it out. A new kid's game. Oh, I get it. You're on the run, and I'm on the job. Now, this is a video game I can't lose. Keep it down, Nico. Genius at work. Oh, I lost. The new kids snuck away again.
Hello.
Here you go, Joe. Riverside High.
Hi, a real school.
Whoa, clothes make the kid gotta look in.
In disguise.
Hold it. Gotcha. I'd know that look anywhere. You're a new kid.
Actually, I'm...
What's the prob? So you just moved into the school district. No biggie.
Phew, guess not. I'm Joe.
Stevie, I snap pics for the school paper. I got free period until lunch. You want my official new kid tour?
New kid tour? Yeah, sounds hype. I want to do it all.
Relax, bud. You do have all year.
High school feels like I never left. This is happening.
Better lay low and chill. We're on dangerous ground here.
Oh, I see what you mean.
That's chilling.
Listen up, everybody, if you wanna take a chance.
We're seeing why the fans are so hyped by Showtime.
That's right, this school is concert day crazy. New kids have the best fans in the world. But in the hours before a show, a weird thing happens. Concert day crazy! This machine shows the fan fun factor for Band X. The New Kids fan fun factor. Here's a typical New Kids fan the day before the concert. Now watch what happens as we count down the concert time.
No doubt about it, on concert day, the best defense is to stay out of sight. So you see, we're not safe here.
You really know how to potty, John.
We gotta hang with Joe.
Okay, if we have to hide, let's at least do it in the gym. I could use a good workout.
I'm not gonna see much of the school from a dark room.
Correction, you will see all, you will know all. Observe. The student body has its brains. Its muscle, and its backbone.
And where do you fit in?
I don't. I mean, I just keep an eye on what everyone else is doing.
Yeah, but isn't the best part of high school hanging with all the other kids?
Yeah, I guess. You know, whatever.
I'm not the only new kid around here, am I?
Yeah. My parents move every year. I figure why bother making friends if you're just gonna have to leave them?
I'm on the move a lot, too. You just gotta make the most out of where you are and what you've got. So let's go check out the school. For real.
They did it again!
No, no, it can't be. It's going so well. Rehearsed and ready.
All right, all right. What happened?
I wish I knew. We were all messing and stuff. 1 minute, new kids. Next minute, no kids.
School books. Einstein said that Joe wanted to try out a real school. I didn't think he meant today.
Man! The new kids in high school without their bodyguard? We better move.
New kids on the block. Ugh, I love the new kids. They're so cute. If I ever meet those guys, I'll show them who's got the right stuff. I'd like to take on those dudes on the football field.
Football?
You're on. Let's play ball.
What? Who are you?
We're the new kids on the team.
All right, let's suit up. They call me Bruce.
And it's a beautiful day at Riverside High, the home of the Buccaneers. It's third period, Jim, and we're looking at an exciting scrimmage today. The upstart new kids are about to take on Bruce and the undefeated Riverside Buccaneers. There's the kick.
Anybody got a game plan?
Run fast. Run very, very fast.
Ward receives on the 5-yard line. Here comes Bruce.
Ooh, excellent action shot.
Just watching things happen is really whack. You gotta get into it.
You don't kid around.
It doesn't look good for the new kids. Can Joey Joe Mack bring this team back to its former glory? We'll find out after this. Let's take another look at that spectacular pop-up in helmet crushing slow motion. Ouch. Ooh. Did I get first down?
Try worse down. Can't watch my crew lose.
Let's posse up.
Yeah, we're gonna spin and we're gonna win. Our way.
Are you ready to rock?
Yo!
Amazing! The new kids are coming back strong. Look at those moves. They're tap dancing. Touchdown! Jumping Joey Joe Mack brings home the bacon.
Where'd you learn to play ball like that?
We've been playing together for a long time.
No doubt. You're one tough team.
We sure are.
Hey, you want to grab some chow with us?
Cool. I'm starving. Hey, Stevie, lunch?
I'll catch you there. I got some picks I want to develop first.
We better get shaken before the calf gets too crowded.
Perfect. A crowded cafeteria.
No, kids, I think you can take your helmets off now.
I'm starving.
Okay, but eat fast.
Huh?
the seventh school we've checked. Did they go all the way back to Boston to find a high school?
I think seven's our lucky number.
Oh, here we go again.
No, couldn't be. Wow. Oh, wow! What happens when Joe Cutie from New Kids goes back to school? It's concert day crazy pandemonium!
Those new kids are the new kids!
Bruce, no duh.
I hate the new kids!
A minute ago, you were having lunch with them.
How was I to know?
Come on, we've got to help them.
About action, folks. The new kids on the block versus new kids on the block fans. It's the matchup of the century. Incredible. Jordan Knight is down, folks. No, wait. Biscuit makes the save. He's at the 30, the 10. Touchdown!
Just so spike me, okay?
We'll never make it to the limo!
Yo! This way!
Move it, guys!
New kids! New kids! New kids! New kids! New kids.
What's up?
New kids, seen them? So that's who they were! They said something about going to their limo!
Limo! They'll surround it!
Hey, we're only talking fans here. They're just a little excited, that's all.
We lost them. Teddy Bear to Fan Central. Fan Central, come in.
They're not in the limo. Repeat. Not in the limo.
Teddy Bear, our sources say that the new kids will try a counter move. Be prepared.
Can't believe I'm doing this. Coast is clear!
The second we're spotted again, we're history.
Hey, Dick, we gotta ride home. Thanks to the homecoming committee, this year's Buccaneer float.
And we've elected Joe our homecoming new kid. Is that a hype school experience or what?
Let's kick it!
We've got him.
Biscuit, they're gaining on us.
We're sunk.
No way, man. I was in charge of building this baby. She's unsinkable.
Why do you think they call it a float?
School tomorrow.
Can't be a new kid in a regular school. I'll have to go back to studying solo.
Hey, you see, Dick, zero sweat. We'll make it to the stadium.
But it's gonna take hours. By now, they've already started the concert countdown.
Concert countdown with your host, me, Rip Pipkin, coming to you live from backstage at Riverfront Stadium, where the new kids will soon hit the stage. Right now, we're going live to their dressing room for an exclusive pre-show interview.
The new kids are missing.
We interrupt the special report to bring you a special report. The new kids are missing. Eyewitness reports indicate that they were kidnapped by space aliens. Oh, no, it can't be.
Big time band. Never make it. We're gonna be late. We've never been late for a show.
There it is! Riverfront Stadium, Delahead!
Oh, yeah, good!
Easy, man. The homeboys are home free. Never miss a show!
We're a pretty good team, Bruce.
Yeah, but the homecoming committee's gonna kill me.
They'll have to get past me first.
Whoa!
Land ho, dude.
And, when did you first meet the, new kids on the block?
This is Rip Pipkin live with the new kids!
Sorry, man. Showtime.
But I...
Okay, let's do it. Joe, you got a minute?
Sorry I caused so much trouble.
Well, you could go to a regular school if you were a regular kid. If it means that much to you, I guess you could...
Quit the group?
That'd be unreal, Joe.
Oh, don't do that, Joey. Joe, no, no. Awesome day. You new kids know how to have a blast.
Your music ain't bad either.
It's more than partying and music. It's about friendship.
That's what being a new kid's all about. Thanks for reminding me. This is where I belong.
Reaches of the universe is the star planet Symbion, a perfect world until their biological experiments exploded, creating an exotic realm beyond all belief. As mutant life forms ravaged their global paradise, a new and incredible species emerged, the Sektars. With Prince Dargon leading his warriors of the Shining Realm against the evil General Spydrax, he would destroy all to rule all. His terror troops of the Dark Domain know no mercy. The brave, the bold, and the fearless stand with Dargon. The brutal and cruel attack with Spydrax. These are the Sektars, the warriors of Symbion.
When we last left Dargon, he had saved his Sektors from becoming Spydrax's slaves. Dargon and his Sektors have continued now on their quest to reach the Hive of the Ancients before Spydrax. When Spydrax spots them and prepares to attack...
Prepare to destroy Dargon!
He'll have to stop for food and water!
I've arranged a party for him.
Dargon, Battle Beetle needs a rest.
up there.
I know you. You're Ranko. You used to be the magistrate of the Valley of Stone, and they booted you out. I heard you were a crook.
Lies! All lies! And someday I'll show the whole stinking lot of them!
Cut them down!
Spydrax!
We have company!
Come for a free meal? Turn you maggots into stew. Battle Beetle, where are you?
Take him with us. Follow me to the hive, and you'll never see Pensor alive again. Did you take care of Gargon's beast?
I put a potion on the hay. Now their telebonding won't work. The rest?
You'll get it when you finish the job for me.
Why did you lock them inside?
Me? It was Spydrax's troopers!
Stand back, Dargon. I'll get them out.
Battle Beetle, settle down. We'll get Pinsor. Calm down, boy.
Thank you.
Thanks, Mantor. Glad to see you too, Dragonflyer. We've got to get Pinsor back. We'll use Battle Beetle's telebonding to lead us to Pinsor.
Sounds good, but it won't work out here. Don't trust your beast's telebonding. We're in the Valley of Stones. Telebonding won't work here.
Oh, yeah? Well, Bytar and I are telebonded wherever we are. Watch. Bytar, grab that tree branch. Bytar, grab that tree branch. I don't understand it. He doesn't hear me.
Mantor, is that possible?
There must be some strange, unexplained power in this valley.
Your telebonding won't work, but you still have me. I will lead you to Spydrax.
Pinsar didn't think too much of you. Why should we?
What other choice do we have if we want to get Pinsor back?
How do you know where Spydrax is?
There's only one way out of this valley.
And that is?
Through its heart.
The forest of mists.
That'll give Dargon a chance to catch up.
I'm not worried about Dargon. By now, Ranko's leading him to his doom.
Us to follow him. He knows where Pinsor is.
No! You've got to believe me. Telebonding doesn't work here.
We follow Ranko. Come on. We'll lose time if we stop.
What's the matter?
I must have twisted it.
I'll have a look at it.
No! No! Go on without me!
He's right. If we're going to catch up to Spydrax, we have to go now.
Just stay on this trail!
Are you sure you're all right?
I'm fine. I'll catch up with you in a couple of hours.
That's a very uninviting place.
What a perfect day this will be. Spydrax's money in my hand and a full belly of revenge. That's right, Dargon. Keep going.
No, Dragonflyer. Easy, boy.
What is it, Bytar?
They sense trouble.
Battle Beetle! by Ranko.
We've got to save the town.
And still find Pinsel.
It's the Serpentoid!
Run!
We'll head off the Serpentoid. You get there as fast as you can.
You've got it.
Dragonflyer, we've got to stop it!
That'll teach you fool villagers! Nobody throws Ranko out!
Get the villagers while Dragonflyer and I distract the Serpentoid.
Dargon, look!
I'll take care of him as soon as we put the Serpentoid out of action. Get plenty of rope! Whew, that was close. Dragonflyer, over there. I have an idea. Ready, Mantor?
Ready, Darkon. What about Zack?
We're right behind you.
Go!
Get him, Battle Beetle!
Come on. It's up to you, boy.
What can we do to thank you?
You saved our lives.
No thank you is necessary.
Put me down! Let me go!
Certainly.
Ah! Ranko, we'll put you away for good this time.
That takes care of Ranko. But we've lost so much time. How will we ever save Pinsel?
You never will. Spyglax has got him in the Forest of Mist by now. You'll never see your friend again.
Dargon, we can help you catch up to Spyglax.
How?
Get them the Swamp Trekkers so they can cross the Quicksand Swamp into the Forest of Mist.
You know why we're wearing these balloon shoes. It's Battle Beetle's telebonding. Pinsor must be nearby. We can trust it now. We're out of the Valley of Stone.
That's good. Stick him right up there.
Maggots, it'll take more than this to finish me.
Yeah? We'll see in an hour. When the Calderax finishes with you, pour some of that nectar in the hole to bring it out.
Three more days, and the hive is all mine.
And the destruction of the Shining Realm will begin.
Back in your home, Calderax! Huh? What's that?
Oh,
Don't go away, Battle Beetle. I've got something to handle. Give the Calderax my regards.
Help! Oh, no!
The map!
Good work, Dragonflyer.
Retreat! You'll never make it to the Hive, Prince Dargon.
What are we waiting for? Let's go after them!
We got what we came for. You, my old friend, and the map to the ancient Hive.
By the Shining Realm, young prince, let's go!
I am certain Spydrax has memorized this map to the ancient Hive.
Well, at least now we can follow him. Where are we on the map?
The map! Watch out!
We'll continue after these messages.
And the Sectars are special all this week, okay? Stick around because Greg wants to be a songwriter. It's the Bradys next on Channel 56.
Planet Rock coming into range.
Rock's battle moons. Your planet's first and most formidable line of defense.
I understand they've stopped your armies on more than one occasion.
Yes, they have. Perhaps this would be the best time for you to clear a path.
Don't look at me. I'm just a miner. Only quarriers have the access codes. I was hoping your diplomacy would see us through.
Diplomacy? With Lord Mantle? Impossible.
Your Majesty, the moons are now active and locking in.
Open a hailing frequency to the planet.
You're in our sights, insect. State your mission.
I am Kryos, servant of the Glacier and king of Planet Ice.
Not good enough. Prepare to be destroyed.
Wait, this is Graveheart, miner, granite class. I'm accompanying the king and he wishes to invoke the Treaty of Four.
He has some crust evoking that ancient treaty.
Be that as it may, tell Lord Mantle I am here to see him.
In the name of Lord Mantle, the Rock of Rock, I grant you safe passage. For now.
There. That wasn't so bad. Good to see you. I was hoping...
Braveheart, in the name of Lord Mantle, you are under arrest.
We were promised safe passage.
You have diplomatic immunity, but he must answer to Lord Mantle.
Take it she was a friend of yours?
The best. I'd trust her with my life.
Why would you value your life so cheaply?
On your world was cold.
The Ice King and the Miner, as you commanded.
Lord Mantle, I bring you...
Silence! Were you not sent on a mission with my greatest warriors?
Yes, my lord. That is what I must tell you.
Where are they? Why aren't they here?
They were slain, my lord. All of them.
And why weren't you?
I was lucky. If it wasn't for the Sonic Cannon...
And now you stand with my greatest enemy.
He has information that affects us all, Mantle.
Enough! Leave my planet, Ice King, or I'll have you reduced to slush.
Surely you would not ignore a warning from your own people.
He is no longer...
Go, Your Majesty. Please. You can do nothing more here.
Very well. It appears I have overstayed my welcome. But you do well to heed his warning, Rock Lord.
My lord!
Jade, please. This data crystal will explain everything.
Save your breath. You are charged with treason. And you will answer for it. Guards!
But the crystal!
Hey!
Not much to look at, but I suppose it will serve. For now.
Who cares how it looks? Our mission is to destroy and conquer.
No, Block. We were sent here to test the strengths and weaknesses of these worlds.
And destroy their defenses. And the quickest way to do that is with my drones. So stay out of my way, Lamprey. Ha! Void agrees. Beast drones, to me!
Fly fast, insect, before we forget about the treaty.
Graveheart led me to believe there was more to you, rock people. How sad that he was wrong.
Promise me, Man of Stone. Complete my mission. Warn the worlds of this system. Stop the Beast Planet.
You believe this nonsense?
I don't just believe it, Jade. I lived it.
Prepare to deactivate the moons.
I am in position. Stand by for my signal. Now! Let the carnage begin.
Did Lord Mantle even look at the crystal?
He looked. He thinks you're a madman.
And what do you think?
I prefer not to.
Jade. Lord Mantle will listen to you. You must make him see reason.
I'm only a soldier. I follow orders.
The threat of the Beast Planet is real. The cluster must work together, or we're doomed to perish separately. Here, and I'm helpless.
If this is your doing,
Oh, come on, Jade. You know me better than that.
I'm not sure I knew you at all. After you quit the army...
Don't go there. Now's not the time or place.
Don't move!
Like I have a choice!
Seal off the control core!
Feldspar, status.
Unidentified invader attacking the planet, Commander. Battle Moon control core is sealed, but we can't hold out.
Ice mites?
Nothing we've ever seen before. It appears to be no matter bound by a Genesis Matrix.
So maybe you haven't gone mad.
Situation.
The control core is under assault. All access has been cut off.
Without the control core, there's no way of activating the defense moons. Rock would be helpless.
Not if I have something to say about it.
Remember that tunnel?
How could you think of that now?
No, I mean the one when we were kids. The one that led directly to the Battle Moon Core. You and me against the odds. Just like old times.
Don't remind me.
Cryos of Ice to Planet Fire.
It is imperative that I speak to your prince.
Go away, Ice Worlder. The prince cares nothing for you or your world.
What I have to say concerns us all. Planet Rock is under attack by a new enemy. I must speak to the prince.
You speak as if we should care. The problem is theirs to resolve.
We've gone the wrong way.
No, they blocked the tunnel.
So they have.
Armada! Attack!
Do anything?
Doubt it, but I'll try. Get ready. Manual control online. Get in.
Got him in my sights. This was only a taste of what's to come. You see, my lord, the beast planet overwhelms. It swarms before devouring its enemy. Rock cannot stand alone.
And I cannot permit an alliance with our most hated enemies.
But you've seen the beast's power.
And they've seen ours. Our battle moons can handle them if need be. They simply took us by surprise this time. It won't happen again. Still, we do owe you a small debt for your help in driving off the invaders.
You owe me nothing, Lord Mantle.
Then swear loyalty only to Rock, and you will once again be welcome here.
I can't. Our only hope of survival is uniting all the worlds of our sun against the beast.
Then get out of my sight. Dare to return, and you will be executed. Contact Kryos. Tell him to come and pick up his new friend.
I've attempted to contact Prince Pyrus of Fire. His vizier, though, is a bit overprotective.
Then we'll just have to find some way around him.
Not so fast. I'm going with you.
Then you do believe in the Alliance?
No, but I believe in you. And somebody has to watch your back with this ice flea around.
Charming. I must say, this is the start of a beautiful friendship.
Ha ha ha!